What the fuckity fucking puff, back at it again. Hey, what's up, guys? Sorry for the 2 week absence. My birthday was a few days ago, and I decided to have some fun and had a bunch of freaking things going on for a couple weekends, and I was drained and didn't feel like doing shit, and I'm finally getting caught up. Now I just have to record this one and one other video and maybe a few shorts freaking later on in the next couple days, and we should be caught up, hopefully. I still have footage I'm going through, so who knows? There might be more. This one's the week 35 top 10. That was from 8/25 to 8/31 of 2023. And this one presents the first time this has ever happened to me on any list that number one and number two are the same artist. That's how good it was. Alright. And we do have an in memoriam, but because he was a Varian and session musician for the thing, we're going to give a RIP to James Casey. He was a 9-year veteran of the ever-evolving Trey Anastasio band, side projects of the Fish Leader. He passed on 8/28/2023. RIP. Alright. Now, we're getting ready for the fun. Now we're getting ready for it. So, we're going right into the top 10. We're going to start right off with freaking number 10 on here. We have Dan and Shay with We Should Get Married. Because, man, this was one of the best uplifting songs I've heard in a while that I actually freaking liked. Because a lot of the happier songs don't sound good nowadays. Like, they, oh, weird. This one's a happy song. It doesn't start out happy, but it does get happy afterwards. You should give it a listen. Apparently I didn't. What the hell is going on here? Alright. Hold on a second. People, I don't know what the volume's going on, right now. I had technical difficulties while I was setting up. So let's see if that worked. Nope, still not loud enough. Oh, maybe I don't have this up. No, that's up. Alright, so it's this. Let's see if that works. Let's see, people. We gotta go up a little bit higher on this thing. Guys.
Yeah, I know that we just met. Pardon my drunk confidence. And I know you don't know me yet.
Well, pause it there because, you know, the copyright trolls suck and I hate them. Gotta keep going, gotta keep playing them. And I gotta find a lighter right now because I tried to light this with a fucking vapor pen, and that was a bad idea. Where is my lighter? Ah, here's one. There we go. Alright. But it's just really jovial after that. It's got a nice little intro and, like, it's a looted intro and stuff like that. Nice and everything, but of course, because copyright trolls suck and I hate them, gotta keep going and gotta keep playing them. But going on to number 9 and give that song a listen. Number 9 over here is A Lone Star and Trippy Red with Did It By Myself. And of course, we can't even play it past the beat drop because, you know, copyright trolls suck. I hate them, gotta keep going, gotta keep playing them up. Next at number 8, we got Youngblood with Hated. If I hit play instead of this.
My God, what have I done?
All right, kid, I was live, but. All right, there we go. gotta stop it, because, you know, copyright trolls suck, and I hate them, gotta keep going, gotta keep playing them. That one right there, honestly, with that one with Youngblood, it's really cool now seeing the West Coast vibe being thrown onto this British artist and stuff like that. It's really an interesting mix-up and stuff like that, hearing that West Coast vibe, West Coast beat flavor and everything, and Youngblood, and like, huh? But then again, I just learned that Ren is in Canada now from a post a couple days ago. Got better access to his treatment for his illnesses and stuff like that. And he's in Canada now, so that makes him a little bit closer to actually see him live if he gets a little better. Because I definitely would want to see that person live. Like, he excites me more than NF did, and that's saying a lot. But yeah, no, where were we going? Oh, sorry. I smoked one hit and freaking forgot what I was doing and needed a relight. Okay, we go on over to number 7, which is 27 Club by Morgan Wade.
You would call me, are you still kinda high? Coming down from the mall, you was fine. I ain't on anyone's mind. And I know
it's a really eerie thing itself like that, because there's a trend in some of the friends groups that I freaking have and stuff like that. It's either 41 or 43 or 31, and I already passed the 31 one, and 41 is what I turned a couple days ago, so damn, I don't want to end up in the 41 club. Neither the 43, that's shit, the shitty that we have two clubs right next to each other, so it's like, oh, we got a break year in between, and we have to freaking worry about it again for another year, and then hopefully we make it for past that. I don't know. Superstitions, coincidences, freaking correlation theories. It's just too much to put your mind on. But let's put your mind at ease and go to number 6 with Vic Mensa's Blue Eyes. Copyright Joel Second. I hate him. Gotta keep going. Gotta keep playing him.
Imagine it. Love what I see with no. Never look at me cause I imagine it in a place.
And we gotta stop it right there, because, you know, copyright trolls suck, and I hate them. Gotta keep going, gotta keep playing them. The next one, now, I like Ashnikko. She has got a very unusual freaking persona to her work, but a lot of people have been misgenre-ing her. I honestly, that's the best I can think of. Like, misgenre-ing her. Because I keep hearing her on freaking, like, edgy hip-hop things, and she's got a voice that's so freaking out of this world that I'm not even sure if she fits to those things. I don't even know if she fits in any category. But this one's featuring Ethel Kane, and it's called Dying Star. Had to listen to the intro because I played a little bit too much of it, and, you know, copyright trolls suck, I hate them, gotta keep going, gotta keep playing them, but it was an honest mistake, and you can see that. We're going to go up to The Girls by Blackpink at number four. Wow, okay, yeah, I'm high already. I swear, I think if you just add that freaking style of freaking that Middle Eastern sitar, other instruments, I don't remember which they're called and stuff like that. Help me out here, put some in the comments and let me know which one I'm thinking of. But it's just like, when you do a song with that style of thing or trying to freaking get that style and stuff, it's just like an instant, I love that freaking shit. And the same thing like Knight Rider. You make a beat with Knight Rider theme, and it's like every time, it don't matter who makes the freaking song, it's like one after another, I'll listen to every single one of them. And I'll like every single one of them, even if it's a shitty artist. And I don't know why. I can't guarantee you're going to get in the top 10, though, because at least I know when I freaking hear it, but that was actually a fly song all the way through it. And, you know, copyright trolls suck on him. Gotta keep going, gotta keep playing. We on to number 3. We got Omar Apollo with Ice Slippin'.
Coming home.
Yeah, when I heard that note right there, I was just like, wow, that's perfect pitch. Like, there was no flow, there was no tail off, it was just right on the freaking harmony, right where it needed to be, and then melody freaking trickled afterwards with the song. It's really the lyrics, the production, and the singing quality all fit for this song to make it a number 3. That's why. Probably would have been a number 1 if this, I don't know if he's famous. I remember the only country artist I remember with the last name Brian was Luke Bryan. I don't even know if this guy's a freaking country artist, because honestly some of his stuff sounds more like folk music than actual country music, which I know they relate to it, but then again, country music and reggae and folk music also relate, so you know. And then if you want to technically put it and stuff like that, bachatas is also technically Mexican folk music and lore. And then you also have merengue, and then you have other things and all these others. It's like technically anything can be folk music if you technically put that perspective. Even pop music can be folk music if there's a message behind it. Folk music doesn't even have to have a message. It could just be an analogy of something, a story about something, something with a proverb. It doesn't even have to have those things. I mean, that's why folk and jazz are the two freest forming freaking musics there are, because it's never ending and doesn't have to flow, doesn't have to rhyme. It just has to be. It already is. But number 1 and number 2 are going to the same artist. Number 2 is him by himself with Tourniquet. Number 1 is him with Casey, featuring Casey Musgraves with I Remember Everything. Zach Bryan, whoever you are, damn bro, I have no clue who you are, and you made number 1 and number 2. Okay. Right there to give it a little bit more and stuff like that, but that starting introduction, the slow, like almost like a tack piano, but I can tell it's not tack, it's probably just a little bit higher on the pitch of a piano or a different type of piano. I can't tell well off the top of my head, but it's not a tack. I can tell that he's playing it on something else, or somebody's playing it on something else. But then to have the guitar come in perfectly on the same beat, on the same note, but a half step after. That is a tempo hard to freaking keep up with when you add your freaking accompanying instruments, each a half step less than the last freaking introduction. That is some genius right there. I'm going to play a little bit more because the singing just envelops it.
Plains out of eastern Montana, where you told me you were leaving from. You've been stabbed in the back and the rest of your body, won't you tell me where you're bleeding from?
Yeah, those all I have to do is say those words for crying out loud. Like, are you kidding me? Like, when you pull that up and stuff like that, those opening words. These days on the plains of eastern eastern Montana, where you told me where you were leaving from. You've been stabbed in the back and the rest of your body. Won't you tell me where you're bleeding from? Like, that is a man with so much compassion that it's just like, no, I want to make sure you're okay before we do something about who did it. I want to take your side. I'm willing to go anywhere for you. Those are some powerful words. He's got another one in here that's freaking... You bled your whole soul into things you can't control in a world you'll never satisfy. I'll bandage up your body and your bones and your bad days too. Take care of the blood that your love runs through. I know all the damage that some days in the dark, in this dark world does. Like, you were laughing last week at something I dreamed of. Like, who writes flowing, beautiful poems? Like, are you Robert Frost? Because those are just analogies that I don't hear in music nowadays. I'm going to go on to the number one, and I'm also going to keep the lyrics up and everything, because there's some things that I want to quote from that one, too. My number one, we also got Zach Bryan with Casey Musgraves, I Remember Everything. Cover, I troll suck, and I hate him, gotta keep going, gotta keep playing him. This one's probably gonna get a full playthrough, so we're gonna be pausing a lot. I'll do some wacky shit in between, hold my joint in my mouth the whole time.
Rocked up whiskey's gonna ease my mind.
Gotta pause it there, because, you know, copyright trolls suck, and I hate them, gotta keep going, gotta keep playing them. I can't wait to do this song at karaoke. I just need another female singer, which, yeah, that anniversary's coming up. That's why I'm trying to do all this today, and not have to worry about that. I'll just be alone with myself. I died. Along with myself, and whoever decides to watch this shit seems to be the best way for me.
Do I remind you of your daddy in his 84? Labrador hanging out the passenger door. The sand from your hair is blowing in my eyes.
And it goes, blame it on the beach, grown men don't cry afterwards. He's got so many... His songs, if he is considered a country star, Zach Bryan, if you're considered a country person, you are mislabeling yourself so badly, sir. But I understand to get your popularity out there. But your writing is metaphoric. It's inspirational and free-flowing. It's defensive without being aggressive. I didn't know these qualities could exist in one person, much less these qualities could exist in the music of that person as well. High praise coming from somebody who doesn't really like country, and to be honest, until 2005, I really honestly refused to listen to any country except for four songs. Until 2005. And I'm being honest. I was born in 1982. I was 23 years old before I finally listened to any country on the regular. There was four songs that I listened to. I can name all four of them. Stand By Your Man, Tammy Wynette. Juice Newton's Playing With the Queen of Hearts. Garth Brooks's Standing Outside the Fire. and Garth Brooks' The Red Strokes. Until 2005, those were the only... There was five. Travis Tritt's We're Corn Don't Grow. I forgot about that one. That one is one of those songs that I did like in that time. I did listen to a few of the other songs from back in the day, but it's just I didn't like them. Like, I didn't even really get a fondness for Johnny Cash until 3 or 4 months before he passed away. And that's a shame on my part, because I missed a whole shit ton of amazing songwriters and things that I could have developed my head and developed my perspectives even more. I was so in tune with rock, R&B, hip-hop, industrial, electronic music that But I had folk. I had the upbringing of folk music. I had the upbringing of jam bands and Grateful Dead and Peter, Paul, and Mary and Pete Seeger. I had that upbringing because my parents liked them. But because they liked them, I rebelled and stayed to that thing, and I didn't embrace the side that they freaking taught me until after they were gone. I mean, shit. There's so many things that I could have... I went to so many things and can say I... done this and done that and been to these concerts and done this because of all the things that my mom and dad had done and that my mom did after my father died and after the shit that happened and all these other things. But it's still, it's like, I don't understand why I didn't process it. Maybe I had to go older, maybe I had to age, maybe I had to have the right moment in my life, maybe I just had to freaking be sitting around freaking campfire holding my guitar, freaking can't play any more freaking music because my hands are hurting, and somebody had a freaking radio with a freaking country song on it, and it just kind of fit. You never know what some type of music is going to bring you into. I downplayed emo rap for years because I thought it was the end of hip-hop. I thought it was the end of hip-hop. Emo rap, I thought, was the end of hip-hop. I was like, up, all the auto-tune, he's crying and everything like that. Yep, we're at the end of hip-hop. We're not even to 50 years. We just passed the 50 years. But when that first came out, we're like, we haven't hit 50 years yet, and it's going to fizzle out thanks to this genre. But it didn't. People kept listening to it. I paid attention to it. And yes, there are a lot of them that sound exactly alike. But there are some that actually are amazing, and you just never know what you're going to hear. So I do this across all genres because, you never know. You never know what genre is going to be good for you. You never know what you're going to like. So I embrace everything. I will say there, if I took a video of the how I judge things and how I go through things freaking category, you would see you have an hour and a half, 2 hours of me just sitting there going, next, next. You'd hear 3 seconds of a song and be like, holy fuck, you don't like it that quickly? Yeah. And I can guarantee that there's maybe only 2% of songs that I nexted immediately that I went back and said I was wrong about. I've been doing this listings and stuff like that since my middle school newspaper in 1994 or 5, I don't remember, or some year like that. 94, 95, 96, something like that. I started doing these lists. And I did them in school yearly, and then I did my high school newspaper, and I did it in like 3 different college newspapers, and I did it in another form of a writing blog, a blog that doesn't even exist anymore. And then I did vlogs years ago and I can't even find that YouTube channel anymore. And I really wish I could have all my access to all my number ones. I don't have all the number ones that I have from every year. But I keep making them because my friends don't want to hear me talk about it anymore. And this, at least if somebody likes to hear about it and discover some new artists and discover some new things, hear me ramble about freaking music and shit like that. I mean, one of my friends freaking told me to freaking do this stupid shit for years, and why not? I just wish some of my friends and some other people would come along and freaking say hi and come do one with me. We could do a live one, for crying out loud. brown. Oh, shit. We don't even have to do it in my regular setting here and stuff like that. Which, the funniest thing in the world is everybody in the world thinks that's a blue freaking curtain and those are hunter green. That's how bright the sun's shining through it. So, yeah. I've heard a couple people like, nice blue curtains, where can I get them? I was like, buy the hunter greens at Walmart and let the sun shine through them. Oh, shit. Yeah. I guess we've already been done for a while. Another one last song I want to, one line from the start of the chorus on the, actually the whole chorus, I'll read off the things. It's just like a, for the I remember everything. A cold shoulder at closing time, you were begging me to stay till the sun rose. Strange words come on out of a grown man's mouth when his mind broke. Pictures and past and time, you only smile like that when you're drinking. I wish I didn't, but I do. Remember every moment on the nights with you. The way he writes, it's just, I wish I could write like that. I know I'm going to have people saying, yes, you can write like that. I wish I could write like that. That was a beautiful fucking song. Two beautiful songs. In a row. 1 week, you release an album, and two of your songs are good enough to top my every song around that I played otherwise. That I listened to. More power to you, bro. What the fuckity fucking puff. Peace be with you. We out.